Hi, this is Linda and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. In this video, I'm putting together my project life spread for the week of November 4th through November 10th, 2024. And I'm working with a variety of supplies from my stash, including an older Studio Calico kit and some pieces from Coco Daisy. Let's go ahead and dive right in. Okay, so today I'm working with an older kit from Studio Calico. I had marked this as November because when I looked through it, it looked like it would fit for November. So I don't actually remember the name of the kit or when it was from. It's at least a couple years old and I've already used it for at least one spread. I also have the November 2024 calendar from Coco Daisy. I've been using these in here as monthly title cards once a month for my stash busting spreads, but just to include these as well, and anything from the Coco Daisy kits that are dated. And I'm not sure though if I want to use this one because I don't love this drawing. I think it's cute except for the little mouse. He like looks kind of bald to me. I'm not sure. I don't know what bothers me about it, but maybe once I get my photos in and stuff, I will like it and it will stay. We'll see. So I do have my weekly spread here from my Hobonichi cousin. I'm just going to go through and make some notes about some of the stories I want to tell this week. Okay, so I'm still gonna keep this out just off screen here in case I need a little more detail when going through, but that at least gives me a basic list of what stories I want to tell this week. So I'm just gonna go ahead and lay out my photos and go through this kit and decide what I want to do. So one story this week is definitely Election Day, which I'm not thrilled, of course, but I want to still document it because it is part of life. So I printed the New York Times cover for the day after Election Day, which they did not know yet that Trump had won. So when they had to go to press, so it definitely doesn't show that, but it still talks about a splintered nation in suspense, which is really kind of how I feel about, you know, the nation just being so split. And then I have my drawing here. So I was journaling during it. So I think I will have maybe some journaling about the election there. Then I have some cute cat photos this week. And I did a little home improvement thing. And then, yeah, just lots of cat photos. So I'm not sure exactly how I want to arrange that. This week was actually very busy, but I didn't really get photos of a lot of stuff. So I'm trying to see if there's anything else I want to include as far as ephemera. I do have extra I voted stickers, but I didn't vote this week. I voted the weekend before and I included a photo of my sticker. So I'm not sure if I'm gonna use that. I'm just gonna put it to the side and then go through my kit. And I hope that this kit has a lot of stuff to kind of fill these pockets. Otherwise, I might go back to my computer and see if I can find some more photos. So let me start with the 4x6 cards because I do have these two 4x6 spots. So this actually makes a really nice title card. Even with that there, I don't mind that it's a little repetitive. I don't know that I have that much to journal about. I don't know if there were any good things about fall this week. It was very fall-ish. But it was not good fall. It was cleaning up leaves and election results. So not sure what I'm gonna do here. So a lot of times when I have a 4x6 pocket like this and I don't have a 4x6 thing to include, I like to just put a photo. And I also like splitting up the pumpkin photos a little bit, but that does still give me an extra spot over here where I don't have a photo. So let's see how this is coming together as I start to go through the 3x4 cards. I think this will be a good one for the election because it's like, Finn, I'm just done. Okay, and then here's a good like bullet point list card. This is a good journaling card. I really like the colors of this kit, how they're very kind of understated. This would be a nice, just simple filler. Same with this Let's Get Cozy one. And then this, I really like these colors. This is the life. I think I want to cut that one out. Okay, so let me just think a little bit more about the journaling I need. And then there's this simple one. So this will be about the election. This will be just random stories from the week. I need a longer one about Saturday and maybe a longer one about Sunday. So I think I can use those. So I think that that looks good. I like that there's just, it's a lot of like browns, which I'm very into brown right now. And I've actually been using this Sarasa Clip Pen, which is from their vintage collection. And it is like a brown. So I'm gonna actually use that for my journaling on this spread. Then let's see, we have these larger butterflies. So I have a few of these filler cards that probably need something on them. So I'm thinking maybe putting some butterflies on this one would be nice. And I kind of like the butterfly theme of like trying to have hope. I feel like butterflies are kind of hopeful, right? I like this one. I think the colors of this one really go with my spread. So I think I might put a butterfly there. I don't think I'm gonna use any more from that set because they're kind of large for In Project Life. I could see maybe putting one up here, but I like that one. And then we've got some labels here. I do need a label for my title, for my date stamp. So I will use one of those. And then there's chipboard and alphas. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put you guys on fast forward and get this one put together. Okay, so I started with my title card, which I normally do if I don't have a clear idea of where I'm going. But I really liked the labels in this kit. They're kind of like this tan color, and there were a variety of sizes, and I just used one of them to add the dates with my rolling date stamp onto my title card. I really, really love label stickers, so I definitely wanted to find a space to use more of those, and you'll see me do that in a little bit. Now I'm trying to decide just kind of my overall layout and what I wanted to do. So for this card, for that Finn card, I'm going to journal about the election, and then I decided that I would make a filler card next to it with a butterfly and this photo of pumpkin. The butterfly doesn't really have any meaning. I guess it could symbolize like hope or something like that, but I just liked it. I thought it was pretty color and went with the spread. I really loved the muted colors of this spread. I pulled over my tray that has my alpha and number stamps and some inks. These are Versa Magic chalk inks, and I've been using these lately because they work in the Hobonichi Cousin on the Tomoe River paper. And I like them also in my scrapbook. So I was just testing out some different colors onto the sticky note here to get a feel for which color would go well with this spread.
I am someone who has historically used black ink on almost every single time that I've stamped. I rarely use other colors, but I wanted to start using other colors, especially in my journal, and having these available right here definitely helps me get out of my comfort zone with the black ink. I also felt like with the browns of this spread that black just wasn't fitting. So I tried a couple of purples because there's definitely purple in that butterfly, and I tried some teals and blues, and I end up going with a darker blue because the teal from the ink didn't match exactly the teal on that November calendar card that's from Coco Daisy. So I wanted to use a different color so it didn't look like it was attempting to match and failing. On this card here, I'm going to stamp out Election Day as a title, and then I'm going to do my journaling. I am not going to share my journaling here online, and I just wanted to make a comment about that. I know that a lot of people share politics and their political opinion about things on their accounts, and a lot of people also have strong opinions about what other people are sharing or not sharing. So I just wanted to kind of like address the elephant in the room. So to say that I purposely avoid commenting on politics on my account for a number of reasons, not because I don't care or have strong opinions about it, but because this is my crafty space and I want it to feel comfortable for everyone, even if you don't agree with me. And for a second reason, because in my day job, I do actually work in politics, in policy, and I'm in not federal government, which tends to be what is the guiding political discussion in the country right now. In the state government, it definitely has, you know, the same parties and ideas. So I deal with that policy in my day job, and I am prohibited from commenting on anything publicly related to my day job. So I purposely avoid sharing anything related to policy, although I do have very strong opinions about it. Anyways, I'm just going to put that aside. So I covered up my journaling, but I did journal about my feelings about election night and how I was disappointed in how it went. But anyways, moving on. So I have this chipboard piece that says Every Vote Counts. That was from an older Stories by the Month kit. And I really just wanted to use it because really the presidential election is the big election. And if I don't use it here, it's going to sit in my stash for another 4 years. And I really didn't want it to. So I put it on that newspaper screenshot, which I got from the Front Pages app, which is free, where you can capture the front page of any newspaper on the specific day that that newspaper came out. So I grabbed that one the day after Election Day to document in my album what happened. So then I wanted to work on this filler card here, and I found this other chipboard piece, which I loved on it so much, and I had originally wanted it next to where that newspaper is, but I didn't want the two oval embellishments next to each other, so I had to rearrange my entire spread, which ends up working out, but you saw me kind of shuffle with it a little bit, and I will shuffle a bit more because I don't like how I have it right now, where I have two filler cards touching each other. So in this spread, I have two title cards, and I have four filler cards, which is not really common for me. But like I said, I didn't have a lot of photos this week. A lot of the week was focused on election and work stuff, and I didn't have a lot documented. I had a couple of pumpkin photos. I had a photo of raking leaves, which was not fun. I had a photo from election night, and I had a photo of a small home project that I did, but that was it. So I needed some extra space to fill. We did do some shopping and stuff. We had a lot going on, but there just wasn't a lot that I wanted to document. So that's why I ended up with a lot of filler cards, but I don't want those filler cards touching, so I will address that in a little bit. But first, I'm moving on to do my other journaling cards. So because I use these stamps to stamp out Election Day, I like to repeat what I do on other parts of my spread. So here I am stamping out Saturday, and I pulled over the end because I was thinking I would stamp out Sunday on another card to journal about Sunday, but I ended up not doing that. So I had a little bit of a rough Saturday, but it was super busy. We ran errands, just some stuff did not go according to plan. And then we went shopping and picked out a new bed, which was on our list for a long time and was kind of a stressful process just because it was expensive. But we were very excited and we now have the bed. It's a Tempur-Pedic and we love it. So I'm super happy that we took that leap. But on this card here, I'm journaling just about my entire day on Saturday. I've mentioned this in previous videos, but I tend to not journal in Project Life about specific days. I don't tend to write, you know, this is what happened on Saturday, this is what happened on Sunday, unless I have a particularly busy day that kind of lends itself to that type of storytelling. A lot of my days look the same. You know, especially during the week when I'm working full time, and then I have a very similar evening routine that I do pretty much every night that I don't really need to write it out again and again, and I don't want to. And I do get a lot of questions about how I do weekly Project Life when I am essentially an empty nester, and I don't have that much going on in my life, but that's okay. That's part of the reason why I do Project Life, because it helps me to highlight those little details and reminds me to take those photos and capture the little parts of my life. So just looking at this spread, like I said, there's three cat photos. There's a photo of a very small organizational project. There's a photo of me raking leaves and a photo of my journal. Like, there's nothing that groundbreaking. There's no photos of people. There's not really a lot going on, and that's okay. This is helping me to celebrate the small moments of my life. Anyways, that is just my little plug for doing Project Life. So I know we're coming up to the end of the year and a lot of people are considering whether or not they want to do this project in the new year. And I have said this before, but I am continuing this project in the exact same format in 2025. And I hope that you, if you're considering it, will join me, because I will also be sharing weekly videos just like I do now of all of my weekly spreads. So here I am rearranging things, trying to get those filler cards not touching. And I like it, except that I don't like that card that says "Let's Get Cozy" with the black background is right next to that solid brown card that says November on the other side of the spread. Because although they have the rings in between them, they are next to each other, and that's just a lot of solid dark. So I'm going to do something about that. But first, I'm going to work on this journaling card. So I had originally considered stamping the word Sunday on that top portion, but I decided I wanted to do something a little bit different and just wanted to embellish it and add a little bit of details. And instead of journaling about Sunday, because I didn't really want to journal about Sunday, I wanted to journal about work and this just being a stressful season and just a few things that were going on at work. So it wasn't really anything that important, but that's what's going to go on that one card. And then this card is a bullet point list. So you saw at the beginning of the video, I made a list of things that from my Hobonichi cousin that I wanted to talk about in this spread. And this card here specifically has 5 bullet points. So using that list that I made on my sticky note, I came up with which stories needed to be on this sticky note or on this 5 bullet point card and which ones were going to go on to other cards. So that final journaling card, which is going to just be about work and stress, is combining a few different stories that fall under a certain theme. So that's how I tend to do my journaling for Project Life. In addition to having a bullet point list that includes a variety of just like small micro stories from the week, I like to group my stories by theme. So that other journal card is going to include stories about work, a few different things that are going on, and about stress that are all related to the theme of work and stress. On this journal card, I felt like it looked a little too plain, so I added some washi tape from my stash. This one has little owls on it, and I picked it up from JetPens. And then I'm going on and doing that additional journaling on this card. So after this journaling, the spread is pretty much done. The only thing I don't really like is that Let's Get Cozy card, so I am going to address that. I also wanted to add a few more embellishments. While I was talking earlier, I did go through and add one of those labels onto that photo of those, I don't know what to call it, they're like slots that's on my wall, and this is something that I've had in my house for a while now, and nobody was using it. It's just like a mail organizer, and instead things were piling up on the counter. So what I ended up doing was adding some labels to this so that we can actually use it and have each of these slots have its own kind of category, right? So hopefully that will help keep the clutter off the counter. On this journaling card, I had a little space at the bottom, so I pulled over these word phrase strips from my stash. They're on craft paper, which I thought went really well with this spread. And now I'm moving on to this filler card. So I consider just swapping it out for another filler card. Having a filler card here was perfectly fine to me, but I was thinking I wanted something that wasn't so dark. And so I was trying out that one that's like, I don't know what that is, like a tag that's clipped up, and just leaving it there for a little bit while I moved on and worked on this photo here of me raking leaves. So this photo is kind of just boring. It's me looking down at my feet in the leaves in the planter. So I wanted to just add something on top of it. I'm going through my chipboard that is fall themed. I will share a video probably in January sharing my updated chipboard organization, but for now I do have a video on my YouTube channel about how I organize my chipboard. I have updated the system to allow for more space and to allow me to take the containers out so I can bring them here on my desk while I'm working, but the categories are very similar, so that old video is still probably very useful. What I decided to do here was cut this square out that says "Let's Get Cozy" and adhere it on top of this plaid pattern that was in the kit, because that is going to break up that solid darkness, and I really ended up loving how it came out. If I wanted to spend a little more time on the spread, I was considering adding some stitching on there on that square, but at this point, I felt like I wanted to just be done with the spread and move on. I was super happy with how this one came out. I really liked that I stuck with this kind of neutral color scheme, which is not very typical for me, but after doing this spread and loving it so much, I'm considering that I will probably use a color scheme like this in the future. Here's a look at that completed spread. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. And as always, I hope to see you guys all in the next one. Bye.